are letters that were written by Sarah Bagley d'Urneau. Sarah Bagley was a famous labor leader in Lowell during the 1840s. And she, as a labor leader, she at one point published The Voice of Industry, which was an important newspaper in that labor movement. She corresponded with a lot of important political figures and reformers. This is one of the people she corresponded with, Angelique Martin. And Angelique Martin was a Fourierist, that's a social utopian reform movement. And Angelique Martin had taken an interest in the Lowell factory women who were struggling to get a 10-hour workday in the factories. So what I have here are three letters between Sarah and Mrs. Martin, thanking Mrs. Martin for her support at one point, and also discussing some pretty important ideas with her. I find the letters particularly important because Mrs. Martin had really encouraged these young women to start thinking about issues of women's rights. And in this letter, it becomes clear that it's from this correspondence and that encouragement that there is a definite interest in women's rights that starts to develop among these factory workers, and eventually, in Sarah's case, is leading to a critique of both the labor movement and eventually the labor newspaper that she's involved in, because some of her colleagues and co-workers are not so sensitive to the issue of women's rights. Well, first of all, these letters became fascinating because it helped us to find Sarah. Like most women, once she got married, she had disappeared from the historic record. And it's in this set of letters that we find out what her married name is, d'Urneau. And that opened up a whole new area of research for us, because once we had her married name, we could start tracing her again. And we were able to do that. But secondly, the other thing that I found so fascinating about these letters is they're really extremely powerful. And it's one thing to write a book or an article where you talk about the way in which people in the labor movement may or may not have been sensitive or interested in other reform movements going on around them, whether it be anti-slavery or women's rights or whatever. It's quite another thing to actually look at the document, and particularly when the letters are very powerful, get a sense of just how important those ideas were to the person. So I find these letters in particular to be very powerful expressions of Sarah's ideas. Although I think, you know, when I look at her life and I think about the way in which she goes off to these factories, she uses the money to buy her parents' home, she gets involved in these labor struggles, she goes to work with reform prostitutes, she becomes a doctor, she becomes a successful snuff manufacturer. You know, this is a very powerful woman, so it doesn't surprise me that her letters are so moving.